Assalamualaikum. Here I'm discussing about the translation. Translation is the synthesis of the protein, and the main machinery of the protein synthesis is ribosome. It consists of two subunit, small subunit and the large subunit. In case of prokaryote, the small subunit is 30S and the larger subunit is called the 50S, while in case of the eukaryotes, the small subunit is 40S and the larger subunit is 60S. The overall size of the prokaryotic ribosome is 70S, while the ribosome of the eukaryote is 80S. So this is the diagram of initiation. Initiation is the process of starting the translation. How the translation start? In this diagram you see that here is a messenger RNA. Its direction is from 3 prime to 5 prime direction, and here is an initiation code, that is AUG, which is the starting code, and it always bind with the transfer RNA having the methionine. In case of prokaryote, the methionine is formulated, so it is called the FMET transfer RNA, that is called formyl methionine transfer RNA. This formyl methionine transfer RNA first bind with the messenger RNA along with the 30S ribosome, and then the 50S ribosome bind and to make a initiation complex. This whole process is controlled and assist with the help of initiation factors, that is initiation factor IF1, IF2 and IF3. All of these assist the formation of this initiation complex. Now the next step is that the larger subunit of the ribosome has three site, A, P or E, where the P site always receives the first transfer RNA with the first amino acid, that is called FMET transfer RNA. So the first initiation code is always present at the P site, and while the upcoming amino acid along with the transfer RNA, they always come to the A site. P site is called peptidyl site, A site is called amino acyl site. And then when the two of the areas they are occupied with the transfer RNA, one with the FMET and the other with other amino acid, for example in this diagram it is proline, which is another amino acid, then both the amino acid, they make a bond. This bond formation is called the peptide bond formation. This peptide bond form in such a way that the amino acid at the P site, it shifted to the A site. Now the A site has a two amino acid, that is the proline and the FMET. Both it is called the dipeptide. Now this is the step that show how the elongation actually occur. Already I told you that the larger subunit of the ribosome has the three site, A site, P site and E site. A site always receive the new transfer RNA with its amino acid, while the P site has already a peptide chain or an already the first amino acid, that is called FMET transfer RNA amino acid. So this process is assisted with the help of GTP. GTP provide the energy and convert it into GDP, and so that the amino acid is loaded on the ribosome, and amino acid they enter into the A site according to their three nucleotide sequence that is present on the transfer RNA. This sequence is called anticodon, and this the sequence alternate that is complementary to the anticodon present on the messenger RNA is called the codon. Both of these match, and after their matching, the GTP assess the binding of the new transfer RNA, and when the new transfer RNA bind, then there is a bond formation between the amino acid present at the A site and the amino acid present at the P site, and then the chain is shifted towards the A. P site is empty. Then the messenger RNA moves three nucleotide forward. A site is converted into P site. The P site is converted into E site. Like this, in this cycle, this is the bond formation. Then this is the shifting. A site is converted to P, B site is converted into E. The whole cycle repeat again and again until and unless the A site has a stop code. The stop code that is UAA, UAG and UGA. This is another diagram that show you how the elongation occur. That now you see that this is the P site, this is the A site. P site has a met amino acid, and then the bond formation between the A site amino acid and P site, that is the A site has a met transfer, P site has a met transfer RNA, and A site has a VAL, that is the valine. There is a bond formation, then both the amino acids shifted from P towards the A, like this. They P towards the A, and then A is converted into P, P is converted into E, and then again the whole step will repeat again and again. Last step of the translation is called the termination. Termination happen when the A site has the stop code, that is UAA, UAG and UGA. In this diagram, this stop code is called the UAG, for example, and the releasing factor help to recognize this stop codon. And there are three releasing factor, RF1, RF2 and RF3, each for one stop code. And once as stop code are the nonsense code, because there is no transfer RNA with the amino acid for this stop code, so the protein is stopped, the protein formation step is stopped and terminated at this step, and the releasing factor help to release all the apparatus of the cycle, that is messenger RNA, small subunit, large subunit, and this is a chain that is called the polypeptide chain. It is also released, so the termination occurred in this method. And there is another diagram that show the termination. Number one step, as you see that there are the three stop codes, UAG, UAA, UGA. You have to learn these three stop codes, and the direction of the messenger RNA is 3 prime to 5 prime direction. This one is the releasing factor. Releasing factor attach when one of these stop code enter at the A site. Normally A site has a normal code of the amino acid, but when any of these three come in this area, then the releasing factor attach and stop the translation. And then next step, the releasing factor hydrolyzes the bond between the transfer RNA in the P site and the last amino acid of the peptide chain. Usko they remove kar dete hain, like this is the chain is removed, this is the all the other this is the empty transfer RNA without the chain, and this is the polypeptide chain. They are released and they are free. The ribosome is also free, and ribosome is break into or split into small and largest unit, and all are separated. So in this process, the termination of the translation occurred. Hope you people understand the whole process of the translation. Good luck.